this I know. But can't you see, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone.
Hi guys, this music is the excellent Ben Howard singing his song Black Flowers, which I'll come back to you later on. When I was asked to speak to you this morning, I immediately thought I should talk about the Calcutta Cup. Yes, the glory of the Scottish rugby team annihilating England in Twickenham. It's a marvellous topic to talk about, but then I thought it might be a little bit mean to Mr. Taylor, as some of the other England rugby supporters. So then I thought I should talk about COVID and its impact on us all. And I worried at first that everyone's tired of the talk of viruses and lockdowns and COVID, and it can all be a bit dull, especially for you children who find adult talk boring anyway. But there are some fun stories that have come out of COVID. The bad ones, and there are lots of them, they have come to dominate the news, much like Scotland dominated England in the rugby. There I go again. But I think it's really important that us adults speak to you children about the upbeat things too. I really like the way the BBC have picked up on this need to be positive too. Their The Future's Not Cancelled campaign, I think it's great, and it gives people a boost. It's aimed to pick people up, especially children, teenagers and university students who might be a bit worried about the future. But there's so much to be positive about. There's so much bright things ahead, boys and girls. And this morning I'm going to give you a few small examples to help you gain that positive frame of mind. Take, for instance, the birth of my best mate's third young daughter at the end of October last year. Now, I've known this mate of mine for many years. I've talked to some of you about him before. We worked together in the hospitality industry for many years before I retrained to be a teacher. He still works in the hospitality industry, and because of that, he hasn't worked since March, the beginning of last year. But when his little girl was born, it brought so much joy, so much happiness to the family. And because he's been at home, he's been able to help out with his elder daughter's French remote learning. So here he is in action with the little gurgling star at the end making an appearance.
Adieu, bonjour, bonsoir, bonne nuit, salut. Je m'appelle, comment t'appelles, comment tu t'appelles, monsieur, madame, mademoiselle. Je m'appelle, comment t'appelles, comment tu t'appelles.
Isn't that a gorgeous family scene? Love, laughter and kindness will triumph, boys and girls. Times are hard for my mate and his family at the moment, but the future's not cancelled. He will find work again once the hospitality industry comes roaring back to life, and his three gorgeous girls will go to school again and carry on their French singing lessons. And when you stop and think about it and look around, there are so many positives out there. Generous gestures, wonderful acts of kindness that remind us of the remarkable human spirit, human values of empathy and selflessness. Thinking of others, putting the needs of others above our own, helping somebody when it's not convenient to do so. Here's one example, a photo that went viral across the internet recently of a delivery of boxes of pizzas to the critical care unit in Stoke that was sent anonymously by a sixth form college somewhere in Stoke. And how about this for an inspirational story? This young man had to spend Christmas in hospital, having treatment on his kidneys, having already had a heart transplant earlier in his life. Due to COVID, he wasn't allowed any visitors, but the hospital made a special exception for this young man, who had a pretty special question to ask his girlfriend. Check it out.
I was just a nervous wreck. Christmas is my favourite day of the year. All the family together, and to then be here by yourself, it's not nice. I can't put into words. The nurse I had, his name was Keith. He come in and he did my hair and he got me ready. And he was more nervous than I was, I think. I was meant to do it in Amsterdam originally, New Year. And then obviously COVID happened and we couldn't go. And then I was going to do it Christmas Eve. And then I come in here.
I don't care. It doesn't bother me where it is. It's just what you've got with each other, isn't it, really?
I kind of knew she'd say yes. I was hoping she'd say yes, but biggest day of our life. You know, obviously, I'd have liked it to be a bit more romantic, but to be honest, the way it paid out, it was just so lovely.
Oh my God! Show everybody!
I'm now on dialysis, but I do think that I'm going to bounce back from this, because I always seem to do. I am really optimistic about the year ahead and the future ahead. I've got lots to do. We both have.
How optimistic was he about the future? I love the bit about him talking about how much he has to do still. And we can take inspiration from that view as we look ahead to our futures. Having been locked up at home for so long, having so many restrictions upon our daily lives, we can look forward to the return of some freedoms that we once took for granted. And perhaps we'll enjoy these a little bit more as they have been restricted. Being able to visit friends and family, hugging grandparents, being able to enjoy a meal together. Parties will be back on, organising fun days out and trips. Being with each other again, not alone. And there's a line in the music that I was playing at the beginning, the Ben Howard song. And the line goes, "No man is an island." And I like this because it talks to us of our need for human interaction, how we're not meant to be alone, and how important it is that we reach out to our friends. We ask them, "How are you?" We say something kind to them, praise them for doing something. The challenges of the last year have emphasized how you never really know what's coming round the corner. And while we are still here, let's make the most of every day. Reach out to your family and your friends. Speak to them. Tell them you care. Let people know that they're not an island. They're not on their own. From a personal perspective, I feel lucky on the whole during lockdown. Lucky to have my health, my family around me. Lucky to have my job and to see all your smiling, bright faces on Teams every day. So lockdown for me, while it certainly had its challenges and its moments of terrible news, hasn't been too bad, especially when I look around at how others have had to cope. Here's another short video clip of a lady who's had to live completely separately from the outside world since March last year, and away from her eldest daughter. Her story tells us how much hope the vaccine program brings. It speaks of optimism for the future. Enjoy.
I'm genetically diagnosed with a condition that's really, really rare called Anderson-Torwell syndrome. It's a muscle disease and also a heart disease, but it also affects my brain and really every cell in my body because it affects potassium channels. And this has meant that I've been shielding like a lot of people. But we've been really seriously shielding since about the 25th of March last year. We sat down with the children last spring and we knew it would be hard for three teenage children. And we said to them, look, I lost my mother when I was young, and I really felt that, not just the event of her death, which obviously was very significant, but going forward, not having her around, I really missed that, and I still do, and I'm a grown adult, and I really didn't want that for my children. And so protecting me and not losing me to COVID was very important for that reason. Also, I didn't want for them to look back months later, having given me COVID, maybe, and feel that that was their fault. And now here we are, the other end, and I've had my vaccine. And that's what the vaccine means for me. It's not, it is my life. And yes, I'm sure that it will protect me really, really well. But what it will give to me, which is something very precious, is my family's freedom. And family. My daughter is a medical student in London. And being able to hug her after the second dose of vaccine, and that'll be a happier moment.
An inspirational story of hope. You won't always be learning from home, boys and girls. This is just a moment in your lives that you will look back on and you'll say, wow, that was different. And while we're all looking forward to the fun and the stimulation of being back with our friends at school again, these intimate moments that you're having with your families, it's unusual and it's precious. So take the time to say thank you to each other. Take the time to help out. Take the time to say, I love you, to give a hug and a really big smile that says all of that. Be there for each other. You are the future, boys and girls. And what an awesome future it's going to be. Full of thoughtful, caring, capable, brave, resilient young individuals. No, the future is definitely not cancelled.